Okay, my last question. I'm sure almost every interviewer will probably ask you a question similar to this, and that's, what did you learn from Prince? But I'll twist that around and ask you, do you think there's anything that he learned from you? Like, did you one day, you played some tricky chord one day and he's like, ah, what's that? I'm going to use that. Or did he not say anything and then later on in a song you'll hear that same thing and you'll be like, hey, that was my thing.
Oh, yeah, I had a few moments like that. I think everybody will over that much time. You eventually, even if it's by accident, or hit something cool. And for sure, I've been able to do that. But I think most of the stuff Prince learned from me wasn't about music. It just was about a person. I'm just a everyday Joe, and you know, Prince was this big rock star, and sometimes I had to ground him a little bit in terms of, like, you know, because everybody kind of would treat him like this thing, and I just would keep it 100 a lot of times, man. It just, sometimes the emperor needs to know they don't have any clothes on, you know what I'm saying? And I was in my role sometimes to just bring him back a little bit and just to put the human thing on him, because, you know, Prince was a rock star since he's 17 years old. That's all he really knew since he's been an adult, was he was a rock star. So a lot of stuff, he was not in touch with reality as how it is from the common man. Like, you know, he was always like, yeah, Morris, you got to dress like this. I said, Prince, I can't go to Walgreens and that stuff. I think people will run me out of here if I look like you going somewhere. You can do that, but I can't dress up like, they'll call the cops on me, man. Like, I can't look like that and then just walking in into the McDonald's or something and I'm just looking like, I just walked off the stage. You are the only one that can be Superman 24/7. He never put on Clark Kent clothes. He was always Superman.
Yeah.
I like my anonymity. I like being able to go places and nobody knew who I was, and it was cool for me. He couldn't do that. And so he didn't have the same grasp of reality that I had. It's like, Prince, you can't do it. You can't do average stuff, but then he did it in the end. You know, he started going to coffee shops and just going to places and doing stuff like normal people. But I bought him a bicycle, and you know, he had many bikes, but I bought him one, and he just started going to places and doing stuff like with his, and that's what he would do. But he had to come to that place, but back then, you just couldn't do that. And so sometimes I just had to just keep it real, keep it 100. You know, about the religion thing. I mean, Prince came to my house one time, man, and freaked me out, man. I mean, this dude freaked me out. I had to call my wife and just be like, I had to sit in the room and get myself together because he came to my porch. Now, he was in a gated, you know, security gate in front of his driveway, and you had to go. I lived in, like, a little area, me and Kirk, where it was just like we lived in this little development that was just right across the street from his driveway. And he bought our places there so nobody else could really put anything there. He had me and Kirk be there. And he came to my house one day, man. He had Bria with him. And he just told me. He came, and I think I was cooking something, and it was some meat, and he didn't want to come in the house, so he just stayed out on the porch. And he just said, you know, and he just had this whole speech with me. And I'm really grateful Bria was there, because it's somebody that could corroborate what I'm saying. You know, any of these stories that I tell like this, man, it's important that people tell the truth, and that, because Prince is not here to defend a lot of stuff people say. You know, some of these things I hear is just, like, simply not true, because it's like, you know, you didn't do that. You know, you didn't say that, you know. And so it's important that I'm accurate about the record, about the history, and I don't embellish it and make it up. And I'm glad she was there, because if she hadn't been, nobody would ever believe this story that I'm saying. This dude got on his knees and told me he appreciated me, and he loves me for the people that he's introduced, that I've introduced to him over the years, and that he really loves, and the people that I've introduced. He kissed my hand and told, and I was like, you know, I'm on the porch in front of my neighbors, like, they could see. And I'm thinking, it's like, I'm waiting for the candid camera people to jump out of the weeds and talk about it. Ha ha, it's candid camera. Because I'm like, I'm not believing what this dude is doing right here. So I'm just like, I'm tripping, man. So, I mean, and this dude is telling me this stuff. And she's standing there, and he's, like, on his knees. And I thought I had to call my wife. I said, you would not believe what just happened here. I said, Prince just came over to our house and got on his knees on our porch and told me that he loves me, and that, you know, he's sorry, he's hard on me sometimes, and all of this stuff, man. When I think about it, it almost brings me to where I was that day. I had to sit down and collect myself. I didn't believe, it's just unbelievable. And so I was like, wow. You know, when we had some honest talk, and it was stunning to me. It was stunning. And I just sat in the chair, and I just like I just had to like I was stuttering like I'm I was like that.